next week in the SummerSlam, whether you Americans like it or not, I will be a fifth-time World Wrestling Federation champion. I'm going to address something else. I'm going to say one last thing. Last week, the Patriot decided to stick his nose in my business. Now, here's this guy, walks into the World Wrestling Federation, the new kid on the block, and starts preaching to me about American values. Patriot, you align yourself with the wrong people. Here you are, you come out on stage in San Antonio, Texas. You've got Shawn Michaels on one hand. You've got Stone Cold Steve Austin on the other. To me, you're setting the wrong example. That's like Bill Clinton walking out with the Unabomber and Richard Simmons. It just doesn't ring right to me. So tonight, in front of all you American fans, I'm going to set one more example. And the Patriot, you're going to just be one more name that I'm going to add on to a list of Americans that I'm going to flush down the toilet.
You're making a challenge to the Patriot?
I'm making a challenge to the Patriot. I'm going to flush him down the toilet right here tonight on Raw. And Undertaker, you're the next one on my list. And by hook or by crook, I will be fifth-time World Wrestling Federation champion, and I promise to bring the championship belt back to Canada where it belongs.
All right, so there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. The Hitman, Bret Hart, clearly challenging the Patriot here tonight. However, also here tonight, Jerry the King Lawler, the tag team title will be up for grabs. Stone Cold Steve Austin, along with Dude Love, tag team champions against those Godwin boys.
That's right, McMahon, and don't forget, Shawn Michaels.
That's right, Shawn Michaels is going to be right here live tonight.
Do you think Shawn Michaels will apologize to the fans of Canada?
Are you kidding me?
We had an occasion to pick up these pre-recorded comments, ladies and gentlemen, as to who will win the WWF Championship matchup at SummerSlam. Will it be the Hitman Bret Hart as he professes, or will it be The Undertaker?
No way. Because Undertaker could beat Bret on his best day, but Bret couldn't beat Undertaker on his worst day.
The Undertaker, WWF Slab Jam, handsome Doc Hendricks here with you, and I want to remind you something right now. That Sunday, November 9th, the Molson Center will never be the same as World Wrestling Federation Survivor Series in Bates. Tickets are on sale right now for Sunday, November 9th, and they are moving quickly. Don't forget all our fans in Ottawa, Monday, November 10th at the Correll Center. Raw is War. Live tickets are also on sale for that event right now. But everybody in Canada is focused on WWF SummerSlam this Sunday, live on pay-per-view. What a matchup it is going to be. There's seven great matchups. What about the Intercontinental title on the line? Stone Cold against Owen Hart, and let's hear what Owen Hart has to say about it.
Austin, I have the utmost respect for you. I know your capabilities. I know how much you want to cheat, how much of a cutthroat hyena cheater you are. But the bottom line is, son, when I get you in the ring at SummerSlam, even though it's in the United States and it's not in my own home country of Canada, I don't need the fan support because I can get the job done by myself. I've beaten you two times in the past, Austin, and you're the underdog, son. So the bottom line, like Owen 316 says, you have to beat me to get this belt. I'm already the champion. I don't have to beat anybody to get the belt. You have to pin me 1, 2, 3, and I don't think you can do it, Austin. So by hook or by crook, I will walk out of the ring at SummerSlam just like I walk in the ring. The Intercontinental Champion, two-time Slammy Award-winning King of Hearts.
Now, there's two things you need to consider here about the matchup with Owen Hart and Stone Cold Steve Austin. Owen Hart, back in 1996 in the Kuwaiti tournament, under controversial circumstances, defeated Stone Cold Steve Austin. At Canadian Stampede in Calgary, Alberta, Owen Hart pinned Stone Cold Steve Austin. But imagine if you're Stone Cold Steve Austin. You would use anything, including the kitchen sink, not to have the defining moment of your career be that you had to kiss Owen Hart we know where. And that's just one of the great matches.
Everybody pumped up for Raw. And speaking of pumped up, here they come, Los Barriquas.
The following tag team attraction is scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit.
Los Barriquas had an occasion to mention their matchup with the Legion of Boom here tonight, as well as their collision at SummerSlam with the Disciples of Apocalypse this Sunday night. Here's what Los Barriquas had to say.
I'm doing tonight. It's two of you guys, it's four of us, and we are like brothers. And DOA is SummerSlam. It's four of you guys, four of us. After SummerSlam, there's not gonna be nobody from you through DOA. Nobody! Venga bien preparado, porque en SummerSlam estamos en nuestra casa, New York City, Jersey. Así que nadie va a parar a los boricuas. Nobody to stop los boricuas!
They are something, ladies and gentlemen. Los Barriquas, and JR, we last saw them in a rather unusual event that took place in San Antonio, dragging a Harley Davidson behind. Essentially a hit and run. And that's what they have here. We'll get a word with the Patriot to find out whether or not he will accept the Hitman Challenge. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
I don't think I like you very much. So this is one time when doing my duty would be a pleasure. Yes, tonight I'll accept your challenge, Bret Hart, anytime you're ready.
And an irate Bret Hart. Marcos, the cast referee, this